Parliament buildings, that's the eventual source, that's where the budget is headed in a short while, about 2:30 p.m. is Hudheifa Aden, who will be reporting from Parliament, and he now joins us live also. Hudheifa, good afternoon. Obviously, we know that Parliament is getting ready to receive the CS. They'll be debating this budget much, much later, but for now, what are you talking about from Parliament? Who are you talking to, and what are you telling them, or what are they telling you from Parliament, Hudheifa?
Good afternoon, Ken. Of course, it is a busy day here at the National Assembly, where Henry Rotich, the Cabinet Secretary for the National Treasury, is expected to, of course, share the budget statement later in the afternoon and, of course, address a number of things that Kenyans are looking at, of course, as the government prepares the 3 trillion shilling budget, which is one of the biggest budgets to be ever prepared in the region, actually, beyond Kenya. You'd also remember there are a number of issues, including the debt issue, of course, as we had mentioned earlier today, that our public debt is standing at 5 trillion shillings. Of course, that is past 60% to the GDP, as a number of analysts are saying. And, of course, goes back to the warnings that IMF and a number of economists have made. But also beyond that, we are looking at taxation to consumers. You remember the Income Tax Bill 2018 is to be presented before Parliament later today by the Henry Rotich, as government moves to, of course, raise taxation. You remember that in 2018-2019, the Cabinet Secretary of National Treasury is expected Kenya Revenue Authority to raise as much as 1.74 trillion shillings. And you remember that KRA has, of course, a number of times failed to meet these targets, but we'll be looking at how maybe, of course, the measures that would be taken would be adopted by the National Treasury as they seek to, of course, raise as much. There is also an issue about the 16% VAT of the current prices of petroleum products. There is the issue about, of course, our economy being 9 trillion and having 5 trillion in debt. You remember, of course, as we had mentioned, we'd see how the government intends to maybe tame the outcry that is around public debt. But of course, much more than anything else, a lot of people are calling this the Big Four budget. Of course, President Uhuru Kenyatta has identified four key pillars which he wants to be identified with, including affordable housing, including healthcare, including, of course, raising the contribution of manufacturing to the GDP, and much more than anything else, healthcare. And I've seen a number of MPs really walk in and out of Parliament, and they are able to share their perspective with us. Also, it's a really busy day here in Parliament. Of course, many committees sit and engage and speak to vet a number of cabinet secretaries. Cabinet Secretary for Agriculture, Mwangi Kinjuri, is inside speaking to the Agriculture Committee. And I've also identified the IBC chairman, who was here a short while ago with his commissioners, and I am meant to believe that he was speaking to the Justice and Legal Affairs of Parliament. But much more than anything else, I am joined by the Member of Parliament for Kiambu County, who is Gathoni wa Muchomba, to maybe share her perspectives about this budget, which has been identified as the Big Four budget of President Uhuru Kenyatta's second term. Of course, good afternoon, Madam MP, and maybe you tell us what you're looking for in the budget today.
Thank you very much. Today is a very good day for us. We have been looking forward to having this day. And I do believe that every member of parliament is actually anxious to be able to see whether what we recommended during our committees, which is actually the platform where members of parliament are able to deliberate and pass departmental budgets, whether whatever we recommended in those committees is what is going to be read today. However, I am happy that today we are ready, and we are looking forward to hearing what is inside the budget as we had recommended. And for me, as a woman leader, I'm really excited, because I know that His Excellency the President is actually very keen on the four and the Big Four development agenda. And more specifically, I'm excited about the food security, because once a country has sufficient food, it is very easy for us to be able to jumpstart the other sectors. But without food, it becomes completely impossible. It is impossible for you to be able to execute a good healthcare system when people are hungry. It is impossible for you to educate people through formal schools when people are hungry. It is completely impossible to boost industrialization when people are hungry. So for me, the fundamental issue is how to make sure that we deliver the food security agenda. And I'm very excited because I do believe that whatever was submitted, whatever was deliberated on by members of parliament, it's something that is going to make sure that we give the country the platform to jumpstart the economy.
Shall we then a bit speak about maybe the taxation, of course, that as Kenya Revenue Authority is supposed to raise the contribution from Kenyans. And a lot of people are really worried about what really this means for them. You remember that we are struggling. Of course, our country's growth economy, of course, has stagnated for a while now. And a number of people are thinking, if you tax us more, we'd not be able to even have to pay or put food on the table.
I think, just like I have said, if you're able to provide affordable food, if you're able to provide sufficient food and the country has sufficient and has enough, then it becomes very easy for you to be able even to tax people on other areas. But if people have no food, then it becomes irrelevant. So for me, I'm saying the platform that will give us the basis of revamp, of our economic revamp, would be food security. So if I have insufficient food and affordable food, then if I'm told to be taxed for machinery or I'm taxed for fuel, I will afford. So I think what we need to do is to fill the loophole for foods in the households. Once the food is available and is affordable, it is very easy for us to sustain even the taxation that has been proposed.
Thank you so much, Madam MP. And of course, one more actually, if I am able to speak to the Nandi senator, who would be able maybe to tell us a bit about the corruption cases in this country and how this is affecting farmers. You remember that Nandi is an agricultural county. Maybe if you would speak to us briefly, what are your expectations today, the budget?
No, I expect that more will be allocated to agriculture sector, especially the four pillars of the president is food security and also to stimulate the issues of agriculture in this country going forward. I know it comes at the backdrop of a maize scam that we experienced, but yesterday we had a meeting with DPP, with the Senate Committee on Justice Legal Affairs, and they have told us the challenges. So we are looking also to increase resource allocation in fighting against corruption, especially to DCI, DPP, and ESCC, so that even as we allocate more money in terms of spending in this country, we can ensure we protect those resources by ensuring. And finally, on the audit of the county allocations, we must strengthen, and as a Senate, we have ensured that we have put the necessary places, necessary mechanisms through the PAC, and we are also empowering county assembly so that as they prepare budgets, they can do proper auditing going forward. So we expect a lot from this budget, but we must ensure that we protect the resources we allocate to our counties.
Thank you so much, Senator. And of course, finally, if of course, Ken, you'd allow me this, I've seen one representative of the northern counties, and maybe she would be telling us, woman representative for Wajir, really, what are you looking forward to the budget today?
Actually, we are looking forward to see, especially the people of the northern, the pastoralists, the people who do livestock, and especially the Garissa University. More budget allocation be taken to that side so that it benefits the people from Nondona, the bad roads, the livestock, the people who do the youths from there, the women empowerment programs such as women empowerment funds, like youths and so on.
Thank you so much. We'll be able to speak to you later. A number of MPs who share different perspectives on what they're looking forward to, really. But much more than anything else, the Big Four agenda of President Uhuru Kenyatta, we would remain here and, of course, get you the perspective of every MP who's working here and even the citizens from different parts. My colleague Alex is at Treasury and will be telling us what Henry Rotich and his Treasury mandarins are looking at today. Back to you, Ken.
Right. Thank you, Hudheifa Aden. It's been described as the most ambitious and the biggest budget of our time. All right, it's not the only thing we're talking about. Let's go to the streets now because you have a perspective. Today we ran a headline on the Daily Nation. This budget will hit you where it hurts the most. Let's